What's up, everybody? Jordan here with ICT Sports Cards, coming to you with another mail day and personal box break video. I also threw in some gifts that I got since this is our first video after the holiday season. Threw in a couple Christmas gifts that I wanted to show off in here as well. Before we get into that, though, if you or watching this video on our YouTube page, which is where it's going to be posted, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to our channel here. And then if you aren't already in our Facebook group, which a lot of buy, sell, and trade deals go on, and then we also do some box breaks in the Facebook group, but then we also have a Instagram and Twitter page. So this is a QR code for our Facebook group, so make sure you join the Facebook group. And then, like I said, like, comment, and subscribe in the video for more content. And so we will first get into a couple gifts, like I said, that I got for Christmas. I hope everybody had a great holiday season. And first off, I had my brother, Mitch, who got me back into the hobby, actually, last Christmas. And been strong ever since. But he easily, hands down, one Christmas, he got me a few gifts here that I'm going to show off that were just out of the park, just blew me away. They were great. A lot of people might not think they're anything too special, too crazy, but I mean, they're just great. So first off, he got me a redemption here. I won't slow reveal it or anything. We're not in a break or anything, but it's a pretty cool immaculate card, a Clyde Edwards-Helaire. As you can see, I do have a pretty strong CEH collection. So he got me a immaculate collection signature patches rookie, so basically an RPA from Immaculate, which actually shipped right before Christmas, and I don't have it in hand now at the moment, but it was shipped and received at my shipping point, so I will be receiving that very soon, and we'll have another video with revealing that. So yeah, that was one gift that I got from my brother Mitch, and then he also got this that I think Higgy maybe got in a break that he was in. And yeah, Patrick Mahomes, PSA 10 out of Luminance 2020. So nothing too crazy, but a great PSA 10. I believe it's only a pop 7. And out of 299. So this is the gold out of 2020 Luminance. So and there's the 299. I believe it is 183 out of 299. So yeah. Cool first PSA 10 Chiefs card, and yeah, pretty cool card. So both of those were from my brother Mitch, and then last but not least, certainly not least, one of my favorite cards probably in my collection right now for sure. It is a Clyde Edwards-Helaire limited RPA on card auto, numbered out of 10. As you can see, this is the rookie. This is the O, and then I speculate that this is the K, because you can see how it would, you know, a K would be here potentially. And so yeah, very cool card. He actually has had this for a while and knew that I've had my eye on it and really liked it. I believe it's like an emerald, or no, not emerald, an amethyst, I believe, is the 5 out of 10. I believe it's kind of a purple foil, if you can see there. Sorry, I kind of got the ring light in the glare, but yeah, you can see it's like a purple foil, blue on card ink, straight from Panini, sealed. I don't think I'll ever take it out of there. It's not worth sending to grade or anything. I'd rather just keep it factory sealed like that. That's my opinion, but so very cool. Let's get these put up here. I don't know what I'm doing putting them down here. And then we'll get into the mail day portion. So these were my gifts that I, like I mentioned, that I received, and then, sorry. This is a package on a deal that I made, and got this card for a very good deal, I would assume. Or I would say, not assume, but I would say it was a good deal. Sorry guys, let me get some of the mess here straightened out. Yeah, let's just pull this out here. It is my first SGC slab, if you can see here. It's an SGC 10. It is a CEH gold disco, number 2 out of 10. SGC 10. And as you can see, it's serial numbered out of 2 out of 10. It's the gold disco prism out of Select. I believe that's the premier level. Yeah, premier level gold. I've seen some of the field level, of course, is going to be a little bit higher end, but then like even club level, concourse level gold discos numbered out of 10, in the $400 and $500, $600 range. I didn't pay anywhere near that. I believe, the guy that got it from, that I bought it from, got it for an even cheaper deal, but it was a mutually good deal. So very, very cool. If you ask me, let's put that up there. And then the last little bit of our mail day. Sorry, I had my little mini fridge in the room kick on there. Last part of the mail day. Man, that gold disco really looks cool. There. You know what? Let's see if we can switch these around and make that. Cool. Sorry about that. Last part of our mail day here before we get into our personal box break, which is this absolute football blaster. Last part of mail day is a package I've been waiting on for a while. My first actually HGA submission is in this box. And it was a 10-day submission that I know they're backed up, and I was expecting it to be 22 business days, but it was even well beyond the 22 business days that I expected. That's perfectly fine. I'm just glad I got it. I'm not going to complain anymore about it, but I've even had it sitting on my table here for quite some time, just because, I don't know, I think I was just so relieved to get it. I was talking to a friend about it today. I think I was just so relieved to get this package that then once I got it, I was just like, I just wanted to not even think about it for a while. So, it's got a security seal. It was, I mean, I would consider a fairly valuable card, even as an HGA slab. And I'll explain why as we open it up, or once we get it opened up. But yeah, it's been sitting here for a while. I'm kind of anxious to get into it. It seems like it's pretty well packaged, HGA. They, even though they were swamped and everything, they did a great job customer service wise and everything like that. I will give them that. I'll probably let them catch up a little bit before I decide if I'm gonna ever submit again to them. And that's not any slight against them or anything like that. I feel like they've got a kind of cool custom slab, and hopefully they gain a little bit more of a stronger market hold, but we'll see. But let's see, I'm not sure if it's going to be concealed. No, not really. Let's see here. I believe pretty well packaged. Bubble wrap, lots of nice bubble wrap here. And then we've got the slab in its own little bubble wrap thing. One thing that is going to be a surprise to me is this does have a custom label on it as an HGA slab, which is, like I said, a perk that they have, in my opinion. So that's going to be they don't show you with the custom label, to my knowledge at least. I even asked and they said no, they wouldn't show me. So I know the grade, but I don't know what the label is going to look like. So that'll be cool. So let me see if I can, you know what, let's just open it up. Let's not even do a slow reveal or anything like that. We've got a HGA 9, Josh Allen downtown. And as you can see, the corners, edges, and centering did great. I kind of knew it was going to have some surface issues going in. But I also know that the surface issues it has can be probably wiped or cleaned, if you will. I just didn't want to take that risk. I just wanted to at least get it subbed to a place like HGA preliminary to check all of the other aspects. And this one is a prime candidate for resubmission, in my opinion. So I'm not quite sure if I will crack this slab and do that myself, or maybe just sell this slab as is. Maybe somebody just likes the custom label. I'm honestly not a huge fan of the custom label. It's nothing. I did put in a request. They let you comment, and I said, don't put Buffalo wings, because I've seen Buffalo cards, primarily this Josh Allen, with some Buffalo wings on the label, and I wasn't a fan of that. So they went with something that matched the cards, with the lighthouse here and some Buffalo. So that's it is what it is. It's an HGA 9. Like I said, prime candidate for resubmission. And I don't even know, it's going to be hard to tell just because the surface issues really are superficial. There's no dents or dimples or any print lines like some of these downtowns are known for having, like the hardcore print lines. No issues like that. It's just some swirls that I think honestly might even be like some of the wax coating of the card that I think can honestly be wiped off. But I would, like I said, didn't want to do any damage to the card trying to clean that. So I thought, let me just send it in as is and test that. So looks great. It might even just be a hold for me for a while just because it is great. I'm not a huge fan, like I said, of the label, but I don't hate it. So that's cool. Glad to have that back in my possession, like I said. So let's do a little reorganizing here. Have these out for our, hopefully we get some good luck. This box was one of several that I've had for a while. And I don't know, I just have had my eye on this one primarily. Felt like maybe it was even a little bit heavier. There was a couple of them that were heavier, so I grabbed one of the heavy ones. I think I might save another heavy one for one of our breaks, and we'll test that theory if it's heavy. I do not weigh them or anything like that, though. I'm just kind of giving them the test there. But without further ado, let's get into this absolute blaster. We've got, what, 8 packs, 64 cards? Yep, we're looking for a kaboom here. That's what I'm really looking for. And that's what I was saying with the just feeling a little bit heavy. I know the kabooms are a little bit thicker than even the regular cards. So maybe we'll get a patch. Maybe we'll get, who knows, something like that. But we'll see. We'll see here. It's the first personal box I've opened in a while. Let's get into it. And that Josh Allen was a personal rip that I pulled myself from one of the very few. I think I only opened 2 blasters maybe, and of Donruss myself, and that what came out of one of them. So hopefully we can pull something out of Absolute. First pack. DeAndre Swift to the Lions. Alvin Kamara. Andy Dalton. There's a Trevor Lawrence insert rookie. Michael Carter rookie. Frank Darby. Caleb Farley. And Zach Wilson. Okay. First pack wasn't terrible. a couple quarterback rookies. But, you know, we're looking for that kaboom. See what we can get. Doesn't look like it's in this one. Jimmy G. Christian McCaffrey. Juju. Von Miller. With the flip. AJ Brown. Jeremiah Owusu-Kumara. That's what I'm going to say. Daz Newsome. And a Simi Fioco. See here. JJ Watt, Darren Waller, Hunter Henry, Russell Wilson, wrong Patriot rookie, Ramondre Stevenson, Terrace Marshall Jr., Kelvin Joseph, and Marquez Stevenson. Sorry if you hear the sirens in the background. Sure, what's going on? Sounds like it's going. Michael Pittman Jr., Michael Thomas, Rob Gronkowski. There's a Najee Harris rookie insert. Greg Newsome rookie. Christian Barmore rookie. Elijah Moore. And a Brevin Jordan. We're getting lots of rookies. No huge rookies or anything, but, you know, there's only a couple of those right now. Still plenty. Plenty of packs here. Jonathan Taylor. Derek Carr. Cam Newton, CeeDee Lamb, there's the Heroes, Jake Bailey, Unsung Heroes, I guess, Levi, Javonte Williams, and a Seth Williams. All right. Let's see here. That one feels a little bit heavier. Let's save that. Let's go just down the line here. Let's see. No thick one here. Doesn't look like it. Teddy Bridgewater. Ryan Tannehill. Philip Lindsay. Stargazing. Derrick Henry. A rookie. Joseph Osai. Tutu Atwell. Cornell Powell. Hopefully he gets a chance for my Chiefs. Elijah Vera Tucker, rookie. Nothing crazy yet, even though this one felt a little heavy. Hopefully this last pack has something nice in it for us. Two packs left. Oh. Some of these corners. TJ Hawkinson, Taysom Hill, David Montgomery, Deebo Samuel, Joey B, Jalen Camp, Jags rookie, Sean Wade, and a Trey Lance. There we go. I'll take it. Let's get something in this last pack. Let's get a rookie patch. A kaboom, any kaboom, doesn't even have to be a rookie, I'll take it. Here we go. This feels thicker. Maybe we just got a filler. I don't know if they do that in retail. It's there's we definitely have a thicker code. Let's see what it, we'll save it for the end. Joe Mixon, Patrick Mahomes. We'll pull from the back. Kid Reporter, Des Fitzpatrick, rookie. Hunter Long, Rondale Moore, Micah Parsons. There's a red zone insert, DeAndre Hopkins. I've heard those are kind of short print. What do we have here? It's looks like it's backwards. So let's just do a flip. Pat Freiermuth, rookie materials. That's why it felt heavy. We got a little patch there. That's nice. Pat Freiermuth. Okay. We'll take it. Well, that was the last, just the first, we just had that one box for our personal break. And then just wanted to show those off. So I appreciate you guys watching. And like I said, if you haven't already, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe this video. Subscribe to our channel on YouTube here. And then make sure you join our Facebook group. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter. And yeah, as always, that QR code will get you to our Facebook group, and our Facebook group just goes by ICT Sports Cards. So thanks as always. Big hit from our personal box was this Pat Freiermuth patch. I don't believe it's going to be, yeah, it's not from any specific game or event, but wish we could have got like an RPA, like an auto on that. But hey, it's nice. It seems like it's he seems like he's going to be a solid tight end. So thanks for watching, guys, and we will see you on the next one.